This has been an unprecedented election season for a lot of reasons, of course, because of the pandemic and then all the restrictions and guidelines that have come in place after it. So I wanted to start with what's been happening recently in something that you posted the other day with, I think it was 9 boxes with thousands of mail-in ballots being returned to your office because they couldn't be sent to the home. So I imagine that is at least at the top of the list of challenges you've had to face with this mail-in ballot primary, mostly election, with all the ballots being sent in by mail or being dropped off in a box. So tell me what happened there. How were that many amount of mail-in ballots sent back?
Well, it's a whole variety of reasons, and this is one of the issues that you run into when you do an election, like a universal mail-in ballot election, when you're sending ballots to everyone who's in the voter database if they're an active registered voter. Oftentimes, the addresses are not precise. You could have voters who may be deceased. You could have voters who have moved and not updated their voter registration because they maybe didn't realize they had to update their address. You have voters who are temporarily away and their mail is being forwarded, but the post office doesn't forward ballots, generally speaking. So there are all of these issues that come into play when you just take the voter registration list and mail ballots to all of the active registered voters on the list. There are issues with the data.
So do you have to send or check the addresses or anything, or send these mail-in ballots again to these addresses, or is it
it's a very time-consuming process. Every ballot that comes back, my office looks at to determine what the issue is, and we try to locate the voter, try to get more information. Sometimes it's indicated on the envelope that the voter has moved to another address, and then we try our best if the voter is within county to turn it around and get the ballot to the voter. Some of the items we turn over to the superintendent of elections, who is in charge in Monmouth County of the voter history list, so that her office, they have investigators and they can investigate the issue with that particular voter.
So do you think this sort of delays a lot of the ballots for people who are voting in the election, or and in clearing up all the confusion and everything? Do you think that'll end up delaying more across the board with when results come in, based on how much longer it'll take to count the ballots that have to go back out and then come back in?
Well, The vote tally is going to be generally delayed because of the process that we're in generally.
Okay.
Because of the time that the Board of Elections has to accept ballots, has been extended by a week. As long as the postmark is by Election Day, if people are mailing their ballots, and then provisional ballots are going to be counted no earlier than November 10th. So there are a multitude of reasons why the vote tally will be delayed. This is just one factor. It's just that many voters had been calling our office wondering why they didn't get their ballot. And this is one of the reasons why a voter may not have gotten a ballot, because it was returned to us. So we sent over 450,000 ballots out in the original mailing that we did at the end of September. So far, we've received almost 10,000 back, and we do get more and more each day. And in that list, there are probably voters who have been calling our office wondering why they didn't get their ballot. And now we can put it together and explain to the voter that for whatever reason it was not deliverable, or the voter registration was not changed to the new address, and we do our best to turn it around very quickly to get the voter the ballot.
So does this stem from kind of like a multitude of issues with something off with the address or a letter or a number here or there? Or is it something with the post office?
Yes, there are a multitude of issues, for sure. As I said, it could be the voter is deceased. It could be that the address wasn't as precise. So let's say you live in a complex where you have an apartment number or you have a unit number, and maybe that was not included in your voter registration at the time. You know, it could have been 15 years ago, and now we're trying to get you your ballot, and maybe there isn't a number for delivery. Or it could be that the person has moved to another location and they're still living in the county, but they didn't necessarily realize to change their address. This could have happened recently. So these ballots come back to us, and then we try to look at it, decide whether we can resend the ballot or we send it to the superintendent of elections for her office to verify whether the person shouldn't be on the list anymore, whether the person moved out of county. Because oftentimes voters don't realize that they should change their voter registration address with the voter registration office. It's just something that oftentimes voters don't think about when they're moving.
That was going to be my follow-up question to go off of that. If somebody at a home is receiving a mail-in ballot for either a deceased family member or for a family member who no longer lives in the house and lives somewhere else in the county, somewhere else in the state, or even out of state, what should that family member do who is receiving that mail-in ballot? And what should the family member, if you know they're living in out of the house, out of the area, what should they be doing as well to make sure that the county clerk's offices have the correct information so that the mail-in ballots and all the other correct information is going to the right place?
Yes. So just to be clear, the county clerk's offices don't handle that part of the election process. We
okay.
just mail the ballots out. And then the superintendents of elections, commissioners of registration, update the list. So what voters should do is just simply write on the envelope, return to sender. You could write no such person at the address or deceased and send it back, put it back in the mailbox, and it will get back to the election offices. And that will trigger the investigation and the removal of the voter from the list. A lot of people don't realize that there are laws, and it's somewhat complicated for the superintendents and commissioners of registration to remove voters from the list. There has to be like evidence. There has, you know, they conduct investigations. It's not just sort of an automatic thing. There are laws that are involved in updating these lists. But returning the ballot will trigger the investigation. And what a lot of people don't realize is that for years, all of these people have been getting sample ballots. And oftentimes, when you receive a sample ballot at your house that might be for someone who doesn't live there anymore, a lot of people just throw it away because they're like, oh, this person doesn't live here anymore.
Right, right.
And voters don't realize that they should put it back in the mail, return to sender, and that triggers the investigation. So many people are saying, like, why did I get this ballot when the person doesn't live here? Sometimes the person has been in the voter database for quite some time, and the sample ballots by law have been going to that voter. But when the new owner or whoever's living there receives it, they just throw it out. They don't realize that it's best to put it back in the mail, return to sender, and then it triggers the investigation to then remove the voter from the list.
Last question I have for you, Clerk Hanlon, is this new system you introduced the other day, this Monmouth County Ballot Tracks, which looks like it'll provide residents that assurance and that confirmation that their ballot was received and counted and everything. So how does this Ballot Tracks work, and how can residents go on, and where should they go to track the progress that their mail-in ballot has been received?
Yes. So we decided to, we did some research with some different companies in different states that have primarily mail-in ballot elections. And we found this company that offers this service. Now, this is different from the state ballot tracking system. That's another option. The state has the ballot tracking system. All of this information is on my website, monmouthcountyvotes.com. Some voters have had difficulty signing up for that system, which is why we looked into this other type of system that has a notification. It has that added feature where you'll get an email or a text, you know, whatever way you sign up for. The state system is a little bit, you have to be like a little more precise. You may need to know your voter ID number You may have to know exactly how your name was entered when you registered to vote. So it's a little more sensitive. So we researched and found this other option that you don't necessarily need your voter ID number. And it's also found on my website, monmouthcountyvotes.com. It's just for Monmouth County voters. And it's just another way for you to get notification when your ballot is received by the Board of Elections. And this is a system where we pull the list out of the voter registration, the statewide voter registration system, and we pull it every day, and we work with this company, and it's uploaded to the system so that the voter can get a notification. It's Monmouth County Ballot Tracks, and it's very easy to use. So we encourage people to sign up for it so they don't have to go into the system a second time to go looking to see if their ballot was received. Once they sign up, they will get the notification rather than having to go back on, like the state system, you have to go back in again to keep checking to see if your ballot was received. But this system, you can receive the notification, so you don't have to go back in to get the information. Now, I will note a lot of voters have been asking with either system, you know, when will I know that my ballot was counted rather than received? So our systems are not really set up for like that immediate, it's just not how the statewide voter registration system works, for that immediate notification that a ballot was counted. That happens much later. It could be way after the boards of elections count the ballots. So voters are calling here saying, well, why can't I see that my ballot was counted? Well, the ballots aren't going to be counted for a while. You know, ballots can begin to be counted 10 days before the election by the boards of elections. But in order for the system to be updated, it's really after all the ballots are counted, and then the boards of elections will update the system. So it's going to be after Election Day that voters can see that their ballot was either counted or rejected. It's just the way the state system works right now.
Just kind of adding to all the mass confusion and the delays and all the rules and everything. So I'm trying to figure out and guess kind of when all these results will be counted and at what point we'll find out who our president's going to be moving forward and senator and all the other races.
Yes, this is definitely this procedure with this primarily mail-in ballot election for sure delays the results. And that's one of the things that have been advising voters about, that election results are not going to be on election day. There will be some election results in New Jersey on election day, but the boards of elections will be continuing to count and receive ballots after Election Day, and then any voter who goes to the polls and votes a provisional ballot, those ballots won't even begin to be counted until a week after Election Day. We don't know as of right now how many of those ballots there will be. The election officials are expecting a lot of people to be going to the polls to vote provisional ballots, and that delays the tally for sure.
We have to wait with breathless anticipation here over the next few weeks and perhaps even, you know, months for some of these races. And I imagine for you and your staff, that's a lot of long days at the office and everything and a great need for some coffee and caffeine to kind of get through counting and dealing with all this.
Yes. My office, just to get the ballots out and deal with all these issues, we had to hire many more people. My staff works until late at night, every night, weekends, to get the ballots out, and we'll be working round the clock, really, until Election Day to get all the ballots out and receive voters in person who want ballots. And then the Board of Elections and the Superintendent of Elections, those are separate offices. They do the counting and the voter history and the other parts of the process. They'll then be working round the clock, dealing with all of the paper ballots that have come back for counting, because it's separate offices, but everyone is working round the clock to effectuate this process.
Oh man, what a year it's been! What a process this mail-in ballot election process is, and you know, certainly kudos and thanks and you know, a great deal of appreciation for you and your staff and Clerk Colabella here in Ocean County and all the other clerks and everybody who's working through all this and trying to count and figure things out. You know, and I appreciate you taking out some time this morning to discuss the mail-in ballot election process, how things are going so far, and what we could end up finding out in the next few weeks. So thank you again for your time.
Thank you, Ben.